Hello friends, welcome to Tips and Tricks, and today I will be telling you about that how you can solve a history question. So the resource which I took is this, the resource from which I collect the information is this book, Understanding History, Oxford Press for Class 8. This is not my school course book. I have bought it from bookshop on as you can from Karachi. So this is the book, the resource from which I have took out some questions and information. There is a chapter in this book called Hindu Muslim Unity. I will be solving one question of it and will be telling you that how you can solve it in your paper or a test exam. So I will be also telling you the pattern for this. So please stay tuned and subscribe to the channel so that you can understand concepts clearly and revise all the your syllabus and subjects for your future. So this is the chapter which I was talking about previously, the Hindu Muslim Unity. So in this chapter, the main headlines of this chapter is Mr. Jinnah as ambassador of Hindu Muslim Unity, the Waqf Viladating Bill, the Lucknow Pact, the Montagu Chelmsford reforms of 1919, and as continued here, the Congress rejects the 1919 reforms, the Rowlatt Act 1919, the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy at Amritsar in 1919, General Dyer and the Crawling Order, the Khilafat Movement, and so on, the Hijrat Movement, the Non-Cooperation Movement. Here are the questions, but I will be telling you my own questions similar to these questions. So let's start. First we will read this. First we will be reading this Waqf Viladating Bill. This is in 1911, Mr. Jinnah introduced his first legislative measure. Okay, so I have an idea. Why don't we underline this so that you can see it properly? Okay, but I'm not a lefty, so I have to handle the camera from my right, left hand. Okay, so let's start. Yeah, in 1911. Make sure you underline or highlight the date so that you can memorize it. By the time you are opening the book, it would be easier for you and me. Easier for me to simplify for you and easy for you to understand. Mr. Jinnah introduced his first legislative measure. What was his first legislative measure? The Waqf Viladating Bill. He introduced it, the measure of Viladating Bill, which was accepted by the British government. It was his first legislative measure which he took, and it was accepted by the British government after 2 years. In 1884, as I told earlier, underline or highlight the dates. All gifted. Okay, first let me underline or highlight all the main points so that it would be easier for you to understand and see. As you can see here, I will join you later. Till then, bye. Okay, so I'm back and let's recall all the points which we had covered. This is the subtopic, the Waqf Viladating Bill. Okay, what does it mean? I will be telling you it later, but first start reading. These are, I have underlined main points so that it would be easier for you to understand. In 1911, Mr. Jinnah introduced his first legislative measure, the Waqf Viladating Bill, which was accepted by the British government 2 years later. In 1894, all gifted Muslim property had been taken over by a British government to be given in charity. Mr. Jinnah said that this ruling was opposed to the fundamental principles of jurisprudence. He won the case, and it was a certain triumph for the betterment of those Muslims who had lost their property. When the gifted or waqf property was not acknowledged by the British rulers. So in this paragraph, as you can see, that it was Mr. Jinnah's first legislative measure, that waqf viladating bill. So what does it mean? That असल में मैं आपको बता देता हूँ कि मैं ज़्यादातर इंग्लिश में बात नहीं करता. इसका मतलब है कि वक्फ कर देना, मतलब कोई चीज़ ऐसी दे देना या गिफ्ट कर देना, ठीक है, कुछ चीज़ को कुर्बान कर देना. सो इसका मतलब वक्फ विलादतिंग बिल, किसी चीज़ को ऐसी दे देना. और इसमें मुस्लिम्स ने क्या किया है, ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट ने मुस्लिम से सारी प्रॉपर्टी ले ली थी और चैरिटी में दे दी थी, यानी कि मुस्लिम ने अपनी प्रॉपर्टी वक्फ कर दी थी. So this is the main point of this waqf viladating bill 1911. So this was not a good thing for Mr. Muhammad Ali Jinnah. He said that it is opposed to the fundamental principles of jurisprudence. He won the case against the British, and he gave all the land to the poor people, which was not acknowledged by the British government. The British government said it is not okay, it is Muslim land, why are you giving it to poor people? But Mr. Jinnah didn't listen to them and waqf all of his Muslim property to the needy people. This is the main point of this chapter or this subtopic. Okay, so I will be telling you a question regarding this and how to solve this. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so the question which we'll be solving regarding this subtopic is, what was the importance of waqf viladating bill 1911? It's a 4-mark question. It means that we have to write a 1 paragraph at least. So let's start. Okay, so here is our question written. अब सबसे पहले मैं आप लोग को एक बात बता दूँ, इट्स अ 4-mark क्वेश्चन. सो इट मीन्स दैट वी हैव टू राइट एटलीस्ट अ 1 paragraph रिगार्डिंग दिस. सो अक्सर बच्चे गलती ये करते हैं कि 4 marks का अगर है तो वो 2-3 lines लिख देते हैं या 4-5 lines लिख देते हैं. 4 marks के आंसर में तकरीबन मैं चेक करता हूँ, ग्यारह लाइनें लिखनी चाहिए ताकि आपके लिखने के भी मार्क्स मिलें और आपके जो इसमें आपने इंफॉर्मेशन डाली है आंसर में इंक्लूड जो की है वो उसके भी मिलें. तो इसका जो बेस्ट पॉसिबल आंसर है वो मैं आपको बता देता हूँ सबसे पहले, और उसका तरीका भी बताता हूँ. अब सबसे पहले हम लोग को ये जो हमारी रिसोर्स थी इसको हमने एक बार फिर से पढ़ लेना. आप जल्दी से इसको रिकॉल कर लीजिए, मैं तब तक टाइम देता हूँ आपको. अब सबसे पहली चीज़ जो आप लोगों ने नोटिस की होगी, तो सबसे पहली लाइन में है, यहाँ भी देख लीजिए, मिस्टर जिन्ना इंट्रोड्यूस्ड हिज फर्स्ट लेजिस्लेटिव मेजर. यही पॉइंट अब हम लोगों ने इधर लिखना है, ठीक है. डेट के साथ लिखना है, इसके आगे हमने कॉलन डाल देना है, एज यू कैन सी हियर. अब उसका नाम लिखना है, वक्फ विलादतिंग बिल. अब यहाँ पर जो सेकंड पॉइंट है उसी को थोड़ा डिस्क्राइब करके लिखना है, which was accepted by the British government 2 years later. अब हम लोग सिंपल कॉपी डाउन तो कर नहीं सकते, इसलिए हम लोग को क्या करना है, इसको थोड़ा सा अलग चेंज करके, उसका जो है तरीका जो है पूरा सिनेरियो चेंज करके हम लोग को यही पॉइंट लिखना है। एज इट वॉज एक्सेप्टेड बाय द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट आफ्टर 2 ईयर्स। कॉमा, मेक श्योर यू राइट द कॉमा आफ्टर द डेट, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन CBSE पेपर। And so now we are done with our question. So I will be telling you its answer verbally. What was the importance of Vaukvilla, the thing bill, in 1911? 4 marks question, 11 lines. In 1911, Mr. Jinnah introduced his first legislative measure, Vaukvilla, the thing bill, as it was accepted by the British government after 2 years. In 1894, whole Muslim property had been taken over by British government and was given in charity. As said, Muslim Waqf give their property to poor needy people. This was the pattern to write the 4 mark question. one paragraph at least in 4-mark question, and if the question is of 6 marks, you have to write 2 paragraphs with the same number of lines, 11 lines in both paragraph. This is how we solve a question in history. It is Oxford Press book, so you can check it out from Google. Like this video and subscribe to my channel for more educational videos. Thank you.